Welcome to Lecture 10, Theories of Foreign Policy Decision-Making, Groupthink Model. In the last lecture, we examined psychological model of foreign policy decision-making. In this lecture, we want to examine the groupthink model objectives. At the end of this lecture, you should be able to explain the groupthink model of foreign policy, examine the basic assumptions of the model, discuss the limitations of the model. Theories of Foreign Policy Decision-Making, Groupthink Model. In 1972, Irving Janis published a book titled Victims of Groupthink, a Psychological Study of Foreign Policy Decisions and Fiascos. According to him, groupthink occurs when a group makes faulty decisions because group pressures lead to a deterioration of mental efficiency, reality testing, and moral judgment. In essence, groupthink is a psychological phenomenon that occurs within groups of people. It is a mode of thinking that happens when the desire for harmony in a decision-making group overrides a realistic appraisal of alternatives. Group members try to minimize conflict and reach a consensus decision without critical evaluation of alternative ideas or viewpoints. Janis's basic argument was that the quality of the process of foreign policy making is likely to have an effect on the quality of outcomes that stem from the decision. Groups affected by groupthink ignore alternatives and tend to take irrational actions that dehumanize other groups. A group is especially vulnerable to groupthink when its members are similar in background, when the group is insulated from outside opinions, and when there are no clear rules for decision making. To make groupthink testable, Janis devised 8 symptoms indicative of groupthink. These are: Type 1, overestimations of the group, its power and morality, illusions of invulnerability creating excessive optimism and encouraging risk-taking, unquestioned belief in the morality of the group, causing members to ignore the consequences of their actions. Type 2, closed-mindedness, rationalizing warnings that might challenge the group's assumptions, stereotyping those who are opposed to the group as weak, evil, biased, spiteful, impotent, or stupid. Type 3, pressures toward uniformity, self-censorship of ideas that deviate from the apparent group consensus, illusions of unanimity among group members, silence is viewed as agreement, direct pressure to conform placed on any member who questions a group, couched in form in terms of disloyalty, mind guards, self-appointed members who shield the group from dissenting information. In line with the above-listed symptoms, groupthink occurs. The outcome will now be defective decision-making. According to Janis, the group would now fall victim of incomplete survey of alternatives, incomplete survey of objectives, failure to examine risk of preferred choice, failure to reevaluate previously rejected alternatives, poor information search, selection bias in collecting information, failure to work out contingency plans. In other words, we often assume that those who make decisions in government always engage in a careful, deliberate process that seeks deep and varied information, specifies objectives, considers alternatives, asks hard questions, check against biases in the process, questions assumptions and reevaluate information and choices when needed. Yet, Janis's important work demonstrated that sometimes the process of foreign policy making can be deeply flawed, and in such cases, the probability of having a poor outcome goes up significantly. Unlike individuals, groups tend to be overly optimistic about the chances of success and are thus more willing to take risks. Participants suppress their doubts about dubious undertakings because everyone else seems to think an idea will work. Also, because the group diffuses responsibility from individuals, nobody feels accountable for actions. As explained by Janis, decision-making groups are not necessarily destined to groupthink. He devised 7 ways of preventing groupthink. These are: leaders should assign each member to the role of critical evaluator This allows each member to freely air objections and doubts. Those in leadership should not express an opinion when assigning a task to a group. The organization should set up several independent groups working on the same problem. All effective alternatives should be examined. Each member should discuss the group's ideas with trusted people outside of the group. The group should invite outside experts into meetings. Group members should be allowed to discuss with and question the outside experts. At least one group member should be assigned the role of devil's advocate to question assumptions and plans. This should be a different person for each meeting. Limitations of the groupthink model. Groupthink is only one factor among other influencing variables that could affect the quality of decisions. In other words, one cannot assume that groupthink is the cause of practically every miscalculation or poor decision reached by a group. It overemphasizes the role of non-rational actions and subjective factors. The model overestimates the link between the decision-making process and the outcome. Critics of the model argue that there are many other factors between the decision process and the outcome. The outcome of any decision-making process, they argue, will only have a certain probability of success due to various environmental factors, such as luck. Summary. Groupthink is a psychological phenomenon that occurs within groups of people. It is a mode of thinking that happens when the desire for harmony in a decision-making group overrides a realistic appraisal of alternatives. Groupthink occurs when individuals in a group feel pressure to conform to what seems to be the dominant view in the group. The model has been criticized for overestimating the link between the decision-making process and the outcome. End of lecture 10. Thanks for listening.